Intimidating pictures from an RFS helicopter west of Nowra as the Currawin fire roared into new life today. A house was right in front of the flare-up. It's moving fast, coastal residents warned to seek shelter. And at Nelligan, west of Batemans Bay, another monster. Several homes in the line of fire there.
Friends, yes.
We had to burn down by the looks of it.
Whipped up by strong north to northwesterly winds. Firefighters are exhausted and one cannot contain his anger.
You from the media, tell the Prime Minister to go and get from Nelligan.
And from a female colleague to the PM.
Stand down now.
High emotion amid desperate, dangerous and almost deadly work that sees that first firefighter collapse by the roadside.
I've lost seven houses already in Nelligan. I'm not going to lose any more.
It was close, but heroic efforts saw most saved. 50 kilometres south at Bendalong, near Lake Conjola, fire tearing through the trees, what looks to be a bush cottage under threat. Waterbombing helicopters respond, but flames are soon roaring above the treetops as police warn residents of what's coming. Another outbreak, 70 kilometres south at Batemans Bay, being fanned by northerly winds towards homes at Long Beach and Surfside, flames within metres of houses. This was the scene from the ground, the circular pattern typical of spot fires started by embers. Every available waterbombing aircraft has been called up, this one filling up on the Maruya River. For much of today, it looked like southern New South Wales had dodged a bullet, an inversion layer keeping smoke close to the ground, shading and cooling the earth. By midday, temperatures were in the mid-20s, not the 40-plus that was forecast. But then the smoke lifted and the wind picked up. Suddenly, fires rated as watch and act flared into emergencies, one after another. Several of them were in the snowy region, the Kosciuszko National Park, and to the northwest in the Batlow-Tumbarumba area. Batlow is practically a ghost town after most of its 1,400 citizens fled, but not publican Linda Rudd, not yet.
We'll stay as long as it's safe and we've got plans in place.
RFS Chief Shane Fitzsimmons went live on 7 with this warning.
The dangerous afternoon is starting to unfold.
He had sent 3,000 volunteers into the field today, 31 strike teams, each of 5 trucks, hoping they wouldn't be needed, fearing they would. The state's highest ever level of preparedness.
When the southerly does come in, that change in weather will exacerbate existing conditions. We are in for a long night.
Residents in Maruya are well aware of the risks.
If it gets into the trees, there's just have to leave straight away.
This family packing their SUV ready to hit the road.
I've got everything I could possibly fit. Kids' photos.
Everything's ready to rock and roll, so if she starts to glow around here, gets too sus, we're out of here, mate, you know, for sure.
And Robert Avadia is in Maruya tonight. Rob, good evening. That expected southerly change, has it reached you yet?
Good evening, Michael. Yeah, it has. Certainly not to the tune of 80 kilometres an hour, and it is definitely colder. You can tell that. You might be able to see the trees moving behind me, but here in Maruya, it is actually a godsend. So the southerly is coming from that direction. The flames are in that direction. When it was a northwesterly, they were threatening the town. Now the wind is pushing the flames away. So Maruya, it seems, will be spared by this, in spite of the fact it was predicted to be right at the forefront of this disaster. The southerly is moving through. It's moving up north of the coast. From what I understand, it is certainly close to Batemans Bay, and the threat looming potentially tonight might be in the St. George's Basin.
Michael. Okay, Rob, thank you. Robert Avadia in Maruya.